8 in the a.m. here at South Bay's very own WSGA. Bill Hoyt with you, hoping it's going to be just another perfect day. Sun, surf, whatever it takes to make you feel just right. Time for all you windsurfers out there to roll out of those racks and into the surf. Yeah, there's just 2 days left to get in shape for the South Bay Centennial Regatta on Saturday. Of course, we all know that our own local surf sailor, Mike Patterson's pretty sure that he's got that trophy wrapped up. And just to make sure, he's been putting in 8 hours a day for the last couple of weeks.
Where'd you get your input, Hoyt? Mike's just about sleeping on his board these days.
Of course, Billy Joe Wells figures he's got a chance, too. Don't you, Billy Joe?
Here we go again. Cub reporter's got to have his morning shot at Dad.
Well, who knows? Maybe his daddy will buy that trophy for him. Oh, Billy Joe, that's no way to talk to a pal. I'll tell you what. I'll play a record for you anyway. I was going to play it for Mike, but I don't think he can hear it.
I thought you were coming to pick me up. I see Mike's early as usual.
He's been out almost an hour already.
Touch him.
Unless he gets careless. He'd have to forget to put his flag up to lose that cup.
WSGA wants to remind one and all that Saturday marks the beginning of the Centennial Week festivities. After the windsurfing event, Committee Chairman William Wells Sr. has graciously provided the grounds of his estate for an open house barbecue. Now, I'm sure that no one will think for a moment that Mr. Wells' generosity has anything to do with the fact that he's running for governor in the November election.
What's he got against my old man?
Makes no difference, Billy Joe. WSGA listeners don't vote anyways, and your dad knows it.
flash of literary genius that kept you from making the coffee while I was out.
Some flash of literary genius. I'd have probably made just as bad coffee. How's the ocean this morning?
No, there's a little chop, but nice. Where's Jenny? Still asleep?
No, she left just after you did. She's gone surfing with the boys.
Oh, by the way, you haven't forgotten the committee meeting, have you? I promised you'd be there with me today.
Oh, yeah. Okay, I guess I've used up all the excuses I can think of.
Yes. Daddy, we need your help.
What's the matter?
Mike, she disappeared.
Disappeared? What do you mean?
He was out surfing, about 200 yards out, and all of a sudden we didn't see him anymore.
We were watching him. It looked like he was doing fine. And then, like Jenny said, he was gone. No sign of him or anything.
We need your boat, Dad.
Guys inside. Peter didn't show, huh? Well, it doesn't surprise me.
He has his own reasons, Ned.
Yeah, I bet. The artist can't be bothered with little things like his hometown celebration.
He doesn't owe you any explanations. And neither do I.
Excuse me, Mr. Rosa.
Later. Mr. Wells, they're excused from every responsibility. You can't interrupt inspiration.
Gloria, we're depending on Peter to help us with the regatta.
Of course, I know. And so does Peter. But we had a bit of a problem this morning.
A problem? What kind of problem?
Well, one of Jenny's...
Wells.
Yes?
Washington on the phone for you.
Okay, you guys, move the hats. No, slowly, slow. That's good. Follow the hats. Yeah, follow the hats, Jim. Okay, good.
You want me to hold
them? No, follow them up. We stay on them, and we leave them, and end up here. And zoom in for a tight shot on the big man. Oh, Mr. Wells. We're laying out the shooting schedule.
Fine. When do I get to see it?
Well, tomorrow morning be convenient?
No. I need it in about a half an hour now.
Half an hour? Sorry, Mr. Wells.
Bob, I'm relying on you.
One thing's for sure, it wasn't a floating chainsaw.
I've lived here 30 years. Never been a reported shark sighted. Anything big enough to have done that since I've been here. You have to be one hell of a specimen, too.
Yeah, but the trouble is, once they get a free meal, once they get a taste, they tend to hang around looking for more.
Well, there's still a missing half of Mike's surfboard. Maybe Mike's on it, drifting around out there.
Maybe.
It Jesus. What? They got a windsurfer got on Saturday.
I wouldn't bet on it. I heard you in the Coast Guard. Time to start the search for the boy.
Okay. Oh, sorry, kiddo. Just didn't want you drifting out to sea, that's all.
What makes you so sure it's a shark? Could have been a prop, couldn't it?
Oh, come on, Bill. Look at that board. You seriously think propeller made those cuts?
Yes. But how do we know this was Mike's board? Could have drifted up from Florida from... Well, anyway. I don't buy it.
Ah, oh, come on, Matt. It's not a question of buying it or not buying it. A kidness, and that's all that matters.
Coast Guard's already out looking.
That globe is out there in patrol. Maybe he's come up with something.
This is where we found the surfboard. Now, the current here runs off toward Eagle Rock. Now, Mike would know that. He'd be smart enough not to try and swim against it. Coast Guard's out there looking for him now. So, with any luck. Excuse me. Hello.
What if he's been hurt?
Now, Amy.
What about the boat that ran across the board? Why didn't they pick him up?
Okay, kiddo. On my way. That was Jenny. The Coast Guard radioed in. They found something.
Maybe they have some news about Mike.
I don't see anyone on board.
There's something fishy here. I don't like it.
Hi.
They just got here this moment.
Chris, whose boat's that?
Ed Glover's.
John, what happened?
Found it swamped. Must going up on the rocks out near Eagle.
Where's Ed?
There was nobody on the boat.
Ed Glover's the last sailor around here to get himself caught in the Eagle Rock current.
Unless he got caught in a haze.
That's Sid Glover's boat.
All set, Chief.
Well, Peter, I suppose you're going to tell me you're shark did this, too.
I'm not here to tell you anything, Matt. Two people disappearing in one day bothers me.
Chief! Chief! Chief!
Couldn't it have been something else? Couldn't it have been an explosion? We all know that when Ed goes fishing, he uses grenades.
I don't know what you're talking about. No explosion did this. You see any powder marks here? Look at it. Look at it and tell me a grenade did this.
I don't care what did it. I've never been known to quit. South Bay's having its regatta.
I can't do it, Bill.
I can't? Of course I can. In fact, I have to. There's too much at stake now.
Peter! Look!
That would be the other half of Mike's surfboard. Any more doubts?
No damn shark's gonna screw up a whole year's work and planning. We're going ahead with the regatta. And there won't be any risks.
Wasn't a Mako. Wasn't a tiger. There's only one shark in this whole world big enough to cause that kind of damage.
Gentlemen, there is absolutely no need for you to worry about me allowing anything to happen to my town. More than ample security measures have been taken to protect the wind surface. This section of the bay has been completely closed off by special shark-proof netting, which extends from here to here. Spotters will be placed along these strategic points, and boats with our men aboard will be anchored outside the netting. Here, here, and here. So the actual triangle in which the regatta takes place will be 100% safe. Gentlemen, absolutely nothing is going to happen. You like it? Yeah. Cover as much as you can. When you're through, you'll have enough material to put together a pretty good documentary on Wells water sports security. By the way, I don't want people getting the wrong idea. I'm not saying they will, but just in case, don't air that stuff till I give the word. Right now, we have to keep the lid on it. We'll have a lot more on our hands than a rogue shark to worry about.
Hey, wait a minute. You mean people will panic?
Yeah. We have to avoid that at all costs.
Yeah, it's clear, but it puts me in a rather precarious position. What do I tell the station?
Don't worry. I'll take care of
it. Mr. Wells.
How many boats do you think we'll need?
I'd say about 8, including yours.
Well, we'd better make it 10. My office has instructions to give you whatever you need. Just call.
That's very nice of you, but there's only one thing that I'd be needing.
Aim it.
Out of that great white Mr. Wells. Just ahead. Just ahead.
The great white shark. Affectionately known in the tropics as White Death. Well, that's what we're dealing with here. There's nothing else could have caused the kind of damage we've seen. Now, I know the Great White isn't supposed to be in our waters here, but maybe it's old or crazed or for some reason it can't compete for the food where it normally feeds. Whatever the reason, here it is. Well, the record length is a little over 28 feet. And the only vulnerable points are, oh, hell, Ron. Come on, you do this, Wink.
All right, his weak points are the base of the head and below the dorsal. You have to aim for one or the other of the two areas. Because the great white shark, you cannot scare off. Not this animal. Especially because he's had his taste of human flesh. And he's developed a craving kind of madness. Because it's not this hunger that he wants to satisfy. you have two choices. One, get out of his way. The other is to hold your ground and fire and try to kill him because you didn't have another choice.
In second in his last race. He's got a good chance. So does Billy Joe. Come on, let's go in the water.
Hey, Jenny, is that light up in the car? No, no, not that one.
Oh, the one with Snoopy on it.
Gotta say is you.
lovely today.
Don't I always?
Yes, of course. I'm glad to see Peter could make it.
So am I.
Excuse me. Three men know enough to keep their hardware out of sight?
Yeah, we've gone over all that with them. They have to stay out of sight.
Plus, of course, they have to use them.
Fine. Go ahead with the press conference. We're going to be ready, Mr. Wilson.
All right, I'll be with you in a minute.
Okay.
Gentlemen? Get him started, man. Keep your fingers crossed.
Oh, nothing's gonna happen.
Hope so.
Are you ready?
Hi, Dad.
Hi, kiddo.
You guys all set?
Ready as will ever be, Mr. Hedges. You can sit at it.
You're going to get a trophy here in San Bay, are you?
Hope so. But there's a bandload of West Coast jocks, so I guess you'll give us a run for it.
I think they're wearing those plates just to scare you guys. They're probably from up north, Philadelphia or something.
Hell, there ain't nothing to worry about, Jenny. I mean, we can stand up to the best of them. Let's go. So long, Mr. Ben.
So long.
Dave, please be careful.
Come on, Jenny. Don't worry. Your father and Mr. Hammer have taken care of everything.
Competitors, to the starting point. Into the water, kid. Come on, hurry it up. Right up behind the starting point.
Yeah, that's right. Camera 3, start rolling.
Tourists from all over the U.S.
That's good. Hold that.
Some of the nation's it's LaBeouf. With this, the Malibu Championship event also here today. Looking to repeat his
success. Come on,
Jimmy, get over to the judges' platform for a shot of the start.
All right, Bob. On the way.
Lining up behind the starting line.
Oh, that's good strategy, kiddo. You won't have to attack at the start.
1 minute.
Our local champion. Let's forget that Dave was the East Coast rookie champion.
I'd like to see that shark go through those nets.
It sure costs a pretty penny with all those protective measures of yours.
15 seconds.
Everybody out of the water and onto the boat. Everyone out of the water and onto the boat.
shore. Everyone out of the water.
Out of the water. Hurry it up, boys.
Get out,
Bob.
Get out.
Leave your
boards
and get on the boat.
Get out of the water now.
Grab the line. Get on the boat. Come on, get on the boat here.
Wow, that's it. Fantastic.
Gentlemen, I can't make a statement now.
But didn't you take the proper security precautions?
Hey, just hold it there. I said hold it. Security measures were taken, but not for a great white of this size. I've never seen anything like it in my whole life. I've hunted shark all over the world. So put that in your paper. But security measures, they were taken.
The shark! The shark! It's coming back!
You're the one who made the decision to go ahead with the race. Politics is decisions, period.
Politics is decisions? Paul, suppose we save that bullshit for the voters. All right. So I made the wrong decision. But I bent over backwards on security. Benton and Hammer are the best there is.
But they're not ready for government.
Which means you don't think I should either, right?
Look, the other side's having a field day in the press, and we haven't got much of an answer.
What do you want me to do, go down there and kill the goddamn thing myself?
Not at all. But it'll take something spectacular for me to keep our key people aboard.
Oh. I got a feeling, just a feeling, that you're passing the buck. I think you're the one who wants to back out of this.
That's the way you want to look at it. Bill, I'm in this to win. So I want to be sure I'm backing a winner. Bottom line is that you've got to be responsible for the destruction of that shark. And not by next week. Now.
Getting out of worse spots? I'll get out of this one.
I hope so. For your sake.
always have.
Well, I got the dynamite here.
What are you going to do? Blow yourself up again like a rooper?
Hey, wait a minute. That was a bad charge, and you know it. Just went off a little early, that's all.
Put you out of commission for 18 months? That's your warning. Your lungs wouldn't take any deeper than 30 feet. Let's talk about the dynamite.
Hey, let's talk about it. Just going to be used as a backup. You know, there's liable to be a mighty big fish down there. And then even power heads wouldn't do the trick.
Okay, Commander. So long as it's a backup. Get mighty lonesome down there. You know, you all blown up in little pieces. I'll be staring at that damn big shark all by myself.
Well, thank you for your concern, but it's just possible he's nowhere in the area.
True. On the other hand, could be he's right under the boat.
Yeah, it could be. I'll tell you one thing. If he gets a whiff of that whale oil there, he's going to come around in a hurry. Now, Gloria, in the locker, there's some tie ropes and clips. Now, if we need them, we're going to need them fast.
Just say the word, Skipper.
Yeah. I hope so. You know, Peter, we're liable to see something the size of which we never dreamed of. It's bound to be an experience.
Bound to be.
What if your old man comes looking for his boat?
No way. He's too busy to go cruising. Besides, when we haul that monster into port, he's going to be one proud papa. Local kids avenge friends' death. Kill killer shark. I can see it on the network news already.
Hey, what if we don't find it?
You know what I say? We ought to make a pact not to come home without it.
I'm in.
Me too.
Hey! This is all I could find, but I don't know what he did with the lungs.
He did just fine.
Yeah, I'll say.
Let's see. A glove case.
Okay,
all
you
right.
Guys.
The hunt is
on. Artillery.
Yeah, I got you fine.
Me too.
All right, now it's just the sonar.
Okay, come down. Troy, would you lower this on down? Back it up. Straight out.
Hi, Mr. Olufsen.
Hi, son.
We're going out to shoot some blues off Eagle.
Well, where's your dad?
I couldn't make it.
Does he know you're taking his boat?
Sure it does. He told me I could.
Okay. Can you come back in if the wind turns northeasterly? You hear?
You bet. Nothing to worry about, Mr. Olufsen.
Careful there.
Damn. Can hardly make the shark out.
They use little stock footage. Nobody know the difference.
Hell no, I promised Harry a network pickup. Gotta have some action footage. You might have to dive, Jimmy.
Things I do for show business.
Look at that. I want to have that baby swim right across the screen in living color. And if you can get it to jump through a hoop, all the better.
Take the fog to the bow while I coil the line.
Yell when you spot it, huh?
Are you kidding?
What are you doing?
damn near got you. I never saw anything like that.
But did we get him?
No, we did not get him.
Wells' boat.
Where was he when we needed it?
He's probably out, sir, buying up some boats.
I'd say he was at least 30 feet long, and that's a conservative estimate. Wouldn't you say that, Peter?
Yep. Hit him with two power hits. Just kept coming. You got to look at him.
You got to look at him, Mr. Wells. It was eye to eye.
How'd you get back in so quick?
Back? Back from where?
Oh, we just crossed you on your way out.
What are you talking about? I haven't had my boat all week.
Your boy took your boat out, Mr. Wells. He said he had your okay. There were four of them. Your Jenny, too, Mr. Benton. They said they were going off Eagle Rock.
Get closer, Billy Joe, so I can get a good shot.
Excuse me. How much longer before I might hear something?
We don't know exactly when surgery will be finished.
Thank you.
Peter? I'm sorry.
It's not your fault. If it hadn't been for your helicopter, we'd have lost her for sure.
It is my fault.
Oh, you had no way of knowing they were going to take your boat.
Yeah, but I should have known.
Please, nurse. It's been more than an hour. Can't you tell me something?
I'm sorry. When the doctor's finished, he'll be able to talk to you.
Dad, I only wanted to help you.
Benton? She's awake now, if you'd like to see her for a few minutes.
Does she know?
No, she's still pretty groggy from the anesthetic. She'll feel her missing leg for months, perhaps for a year.
Well, there's no need to say anything now. She'll know soon enough.
Hugo.
Moving. I ran over to you and I started to pick you up. You were so little then. But suddenly you looked up at me and I knew. I knew you didn't want me to help you. You wanted to do this one yourself. So I backed off and I watched you wipe off the blood and the gravel from your leg. And you got up and you stared down at that great big bicycle like it was some kind of wild animal challenging you. And you picked it up, must have been twice as big as you, kind of shook it. Got back on and down the road you went again. I remember my heart skipped a couple of beats. Partly out of concern, but I was so proud of you. Only this time you won't have to do it alone, because I'm here and your mom's here, and we've got a whole lot of strength. It's all yours.
it is. Take us down to 20. Okay, take us down lower. Have a look at it. Now, let's hope he hasn't gone elsewhere. I want to entice him right down the lens.
Me behind it, you ain't.
What's that, spare ribs?
You might say, or spare ribs.
Okay. I'll get that ME yet.
Eagle Rock again. He's made this his place. He's down there now. I can feel it.
Oh.
be back.
That's funny. Okay, let's get to work on the camera.
Do you think this thing's gonna work?
It's sure worth a try. We're gonna bring that king-sized killer shark into millions of living rooms.
And then you'll be on your way to the network.
With my star cameraman.
The answer is no. This is my boat, plus my orders.
No, damn it!
That's my shark, Rod. It has to be.
The hell it is! That's just your shark! Or your daughter's leg! There are other bodies out there, and more to come if we don't end this thing. Jesus, Peter. Don't you think I know the pain you're going through? But he's down there. He's down there now. He's waiting to attack. It's been his pattern just before he makes an attack. And this is the only thing we have to stop him. And there's only one dynamite belt, so what's the sense in risking both our necks? I've been killing sharks most of my life. Well, you have been right most of your life. So I'm the expert here. And that's what it's going to take to kill that bastard. Peter, I need your help. I need you on the ship. If I'm in trouble down there, you're the only one that can bail me out. Now, is what I'm saying make any sense to you?
All right, let's stop arguing about it like a bunch of damn fools and get on with it, Jesus. Sometimes you can be a real pain in the ass, you know that? Sergeant Briley.
Martin?
Yeah. Bob Martin. Good to see you.
All right. This is where I set up?
Uh-huh, there. We put the bait at the end of the pier. We'll have a remote camera covering the action.
Well, if your shark shows up, it'll be over real fast.
I know it'll take time. How was she when you left?
She's much better. They gave her a sedative. She's asleep now.
She's gonna need her friends now, more than ever.
What's the television here for?
Helping for some blood, as usual.
Don't even mention it. I get seasick looking at the ocean. Tide of blood will put me out like a light.
Now, this little baby's special. See these shells? Second and a half detonation. Enough for a charge to open up a tank.
Hey, what'll that do to my camera?
You just keep them out of the line of fire.
You bet. Now you have a chance to live up to your reputation.
Don't worry. Just a fish. Camera jock better be fast.
Can you hear me?
Yeah, sure, man. Somebody get us some help down here before this shark has us for lunch. Call a Coast Guard.
Sure, I'll contact them immediately.
Get over here!
It's all over. At last, our waters are free of danger. The shark that terrorized our town has finally been destroyed. And here we are on the spot with the story. Yes, folks, this is Bob Martin on the scene with our local hero, Peter Benton, who made it all possible. Let's get a little closer and have a few words with him. Ah, here he comes. Mr. Benton, would you say a few words for our TV audience, please? How does it feel to be a hero? Mr. Benton, please, you've got to say something.